Good morning, my dear students. I hope you all are healthy, staying at your home, doing all the studies regularly. So today we will start one new chapter, which is called Population and Human Health. This is the chapter number 11 from your previous book. So let's get started. So students, basically what is good health? The proper functioning of our body and mind and a good coordination among different parts. Thus, good health may be defined as a condition of physical, mental, emotional and social ability to cope with one's environment. That means when you are having good health, physical condition is well, mental health condition is good, emotionally you are stable and you are a social person, that time that is called a good health. Okay. Now, in this good health, if your health is not good, then you are having some kind of disease. That means a disease means the bad condition of our body when one or more of its parts fail to work and coordinate properly. So this is the main thing when your health condition is not good. Okay. Students, in this batch we will learn that what are the impacts of pollution on human health. That means due to some various kind of pollution like air pollution, water pollution, noise pollution. So with the reason for this kind of pollution in our human health, some kind of problem we may face, like psychological changes like the cholera, diarrhea, etc. Respiratory disease like bronchitis, asthma, dietary diseases like botulism, etc. So these are the types of problem that we faced due to the impacts of pollution. Now the first one, the disease due to the air pollution. Now a bad environmental is always harmful to health, you know that, and heavy pollution of air, water and land leads to the origin and spread many diseases. Okay. So unfavorable reactions of our body against certain foods, dust, pollen, etc. is called allergy. So that means due to the air pollution, maybe we can face some kind of allergy, high fever, asthma, some bronchitis, cough, sore throat, etc. and eye irritation. So these are the main problem due to the air pollution, and these kind of diseases are called respiratory diseases. Okay. In this page, we will learn that what are the diseases caused for water pollution, land pollution, and due to the other kind of pollution, what are the diseases occurred. So first, second one is the diseases due to water pollution. Now if you consume bad quality of water, slowly you may suffer with dysentery, diarrhea, cholera, this kind of thing, and these kind of diseases are called psychological diseases due to the careless human practices, dumping wastes, washing clothes and animals in water. So these are the major causes and these are the major problems due to the water pollution. Now second one is land pollution. Like if you see the dumping grounds, the municipal domestic waste sites, this creates lot of serious problems, that it pollutes the underground water through leaching. So those places where these wastes are dumped become nurseries of the germs of various diseases like flies, mosquitoes, etc. So this kind of pollutant may cause some kind of diseases in our human body. Okay. And then thereafter some kind of more diseases are there, like diseases due to the pollution in our inner environment. Like the practice of mixing water into the milk is quite old now, but mixing of unwanted and harmful substances in our food material is simply criminal. And coloring of vegetables and polishing of grains are equally bad. Now you can see that in your food market or in your near bazaar, that some kind of colors are used to green the vegetables, to make the color so bright that you may face that you may see that the food is very much fresh and attractive. So these kind of thing are they generally mixed with the color food. And intake of bad forming substances like tobacco, gutkha, pan masala, etc., alcohol, cigarettes, etc., may cause the inner health of your body. It not slowly it will damage you, and slowly you are going to addict to this kind of bad material. Understood? Now students, except this kind of problems, there are some occupational diseases. Like if a worker are in the occupation of industry like cement, asbestos industry, they may face the disease called asbestosis. And if some workers are in the cotton mills, they can or they may suffer with the disease called bisonosis. if that man is in industry of silicon industry, silicosis, and if they works in mercury and glass industry, they may suffer with Minamata disease. Okay, so except this, there are some kind of diseases like dietary diseases. Now, what is called dietary diseases? The diseases caused due to intake of contaminated food are called dietary diseases. Okay. So, the food poisoning is a condition of sickness caused due to the ingestion of food that has come bad, that has gone bad due to microbial activities on it. So, that's why you may suffer the vomiting, cramp in your stomach and diarrhea. So, these are the main problems regarding diarrhea diseases. So, now we will discuss that what are the preventive measures that we can take to against the environmental hazards, like that if we plant in a large area of land in the near of industrial and mine areas, that can reduce the noise, reduce the diseases and so on. Use of smoke filters and sewage treatment plants in industries and cities. Recycle, that if you recycle the plastic, if you compost the solid waste, then this may help to prevent this kind of bad elements to go through in the environment. Like strict law against food adulteration. Now, what is means adulteration? That if you mix some bad elements in your food, that is called food adulteration. Now, in the 2-3 months ago, that one report may publish that in the mixture of honey, that Dabur and some branded company, they mix some kind of sugar syrup to it. So basically, this honey is adulterated with sugar syrup. Okay, so there are some preventive measures in your book, so you have to go through it. So students, after learning this much from your book, so what is our final conclusion? The final conclusion, I can say that you should check your health properly, or you should care your health properly, because government and NGOs, they can't force you to get medical checkup for what to eat, what to rest, what to exercise. Okay, so you need to maintain your health, you need to maintain your food chart, you need to maintain that in which how much plastic you are consuming. So you have to check everything for your better future. Okay, so this is the main conclusion that we may say. So okay, so this chapter is finished. Now you go through the parts, terms and meanings, and some that what are the gist of this from this chapter. Okay. So in the next class, we will discuss another chapter. Till then, stay safe and stay healthy. Thank you, everyone.